Sharing 360 photos is hard. Right now, phones and computers don't have inbuilt 360 viewers, which means sharing 360 photos looks like this. So while we wait for native 360 photo support, here are 5 solutions for sharing your 360 photos as 360 photos. The first way is through Facebook. If your photo has the correct metadata, it should be automatically recognized as the 360 format by Facebook. If it doesn't, you can inject the metadata by using a tool like Exif Fixer on desktop or Meta360 on mobile. If you prefer to stay away from Facebook, another option is using a virtual tour platform like Cooler. With the free account, you can upload a single photo, then share the link to that photo with anyone. If you prefer to view offline, there are 2 alternatives. Send the file as equirectangular and get the person viewing it to download Insta360 Studio to open and watch it back in 360. A great mobile version of this that I discovered recently is using the Google Photos app. Simply download it and sign into your Google account, giving it permission to access your camera roll. Next, navigate to your 360 photos and voila, you can view them as 360 natively on your phone. This also works for 360 videos, which makes it a great solution for any 360 creator. The final way to share your 360 photos as 360 photos is with a brand new app that has just been released. The best way to describe it is Instagram for 360 photographers. It's called Panorra and it's made by the creators of the virtual tour platform GoThrough. In the app, you can upload your photos and scroll through your feed just like you would on Instagram, except all photos can be viewed as 360 photos. After uploading, you can copy a link from the app and send it to people, and they won't even need a Panorra account to view it. They're also adding the ability to upload your individual shots to Google Street View, which could make Panorra a decent alternative to the Google Street View app, which has just been discontinued. From what I've heard though, this will only be possible with single photos and not multiple photos or blue lines. Links to all 5 options can be found down below. And personally, I use all 5 of them. I think they're really decent options, so definitely try out whichever one stood out to you most to see if you like it. If you're new to 360 cameras, however, and still trying to get your head around the basics, then first check out this video here to get the A to Z of 360 camera terminology, which will help you level up your knowledge quickly.